Digitization is a conversion process. It's when we take an item, such as a letter or a diary or a telegram or any other ephemera, and we convert it into a digital format. And all this really means is, in our case for the Seward Project, is we're taking a picture, a very high quality picture, and we're editing it and we're enhancing it so that way we can post it on our website for researchers to view.
Digitization is the act of taking, in generally in my case, an object or a photograph, letter, that sort of thing, and making it into an electronic representation, more or less, that we can either use for preservation purposes or access purposes or scholarship or a variety of other use case scenarios. But it's making something physical, essentially electronic.
So we, in the past, have used the Canon camera. It's the iOS 1D Mark camera. But more recently, we've switched to a Phase 1 camera because of its curved lens, which allows us to see, for instance, when we're using if we're photographing a diary, we're able to see every curve of the book, and it produces a higher quality image, which offers more detail for researchers online.
I use things that are as basic as an iPhone all the way up to a Phase 1 reprographic camera to image things at high resolution. We also utilize 3D scanners, regular single lens reflex cameras.
There are some tricky letters and some tricky diaries, particularly. Sometimes letters don't want to lay flat. So that poses an issue when we're trying to get a really clear image, so that way there's no shadows being casted, or sometimes letters were folded so much that some of the creasing obscures some of the text. So there's some certain tricks that we use to keep letters flat or to avoid any shadows being cast by trying to keep them flat. For instance, I'm fond of using knitting needles. So my hands aren't in the image, and also we're able to have a very flat, clear picture being taken. For diaries, those, or any type of bound volume for that matter, those are a little bit more difficult because we have to have the support on both sides for the binding. And what we need to do then is also maintain the pages, keep them apart, so that way that they're not flopping back in. So we want to do this in a gentle way, using some type of book strap or a custom-made book strap to prevent the pages from flopping in. One tactic that I've been using to get through diaries is to do all of the right side or the even pages and then all of the left side. That way it's consistent. We're just gently flipping through the pages so we don't do any further damage to these books, because most of the time the binding is loose, issues with glue coming apart, that sort of thing. After I've taken all of my images, I export them to Lightroom, where I make sure that the images look nice and are clear enough for our transcribers and editors to look at. I also do a lot of cropping and editing and image enhancing if it's needed. I try to leave the image as is. I try not to change any of the coloring or anything else that may obscure what a researcher could be looking for in a specific letter. So my main goal is to make sure that the letter's centered, it's cropped, it looks nice, and they're consistent. So after that process is over with, I export the images again out of Lightroom, which serves as our master catalog, so to say. And I convert all of my images using a software, encoding software, to create their own individual files in conjunction with their respective titles, which their titles usually are just a name format, who sent them, and who is receiving them. So all of this must be in check, so we don't lose track of any of the letters, because we do digitize hundreds and hundreds of letters. So once I've done this, I pass them on to our project manager, where then they distribute the letters for our editing team.